Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session we have seen about the error control in data link layer, and in today's session we are going to see the error detection in data link layer. Right, so error detection. So in this error detection, let us know about what is meant by an error and how many ways the error can be obtained. So an error in this communication means interchanging of bits. So the complete data will be transmitted from source to destination in terms of bits, that means either 0 or 1. So here the error is the 1 becomes 0 and 0 becomes 1. Right? So if in the transmitted data, if this type of exchange or interchange is done, that means, that implies the data is corrupted or an error is occurred. So how many types of errors? So there may be a single bit error, a single bit error, and burst error. See, so coming to the single bit error, the name itself indicates only one bit will be corrupted in the transmitted data. So as it is a error detection, in this we can know that the data is corrupted, but we can't predict which data or which bit is corrupted, right? So for example, let us take, so this is the data to be transmitted from sender to receiver. So this is a sender and this is the receiver, but at the receiver have received, see, second bit as 1 instead of 0. So this is the original data transmitted from source to destination, but due to the voltage problem or any other frequency problem, the one bit is exchanged or interchanged, that means the 0 becomes 1. So that means there is a corruption on the second bit, right? So in this error detection, the name itself indicates a detection, that means we can detect that there is an error, but we can't predict where the error is. Okay, so the only one bit has been corrupted. So such type of error we call it as a single bit error. Okay, single bit error. And in the burst error, coming to the burst error, multiple bits, not the one bit, multiple bits will be corrupted. For example, the same data is transmitted, if it receives, see, if you observe, the first bit, the original data is 1, but the received data is 0. Second bit is 0, second bit is 1, third bit is 1, third bit is 0. So that means there is a corruption on multiple bits, right? So in that multiple bits, we call it as a burst error. If it is a single bit error, it is called a single bit error. Hope you understood. Here we can only detect the error. That means we know that there is a corruption on the bits, but we can't predict where the corruption is exactly. Right? So for this, there are two methods to identify. See, detection. So one is the parity. In order to detect the single bit error, we'll go with this parity. Okay, and there is a one more method called a CRC, cyclic redundancy check. So this, by using this one, we can detect the burst errors. Okay, two techniques, majorly two techniques are used to identify whether it is a single bit error or the burst error. For single bit error, to identify, we'll use this parity, and here to identify the burst error, we'll follow this cyclic redundancy check. Right. So coming to this parity. For this, one additional bit will be added to the original data and it will be sent to the receiver. So what is that additional bit? What represents that additional bit? So that additional bit represents the parity check, right? So here the main functionality of this parity is count of ones. So the data will be in terms of zeros and ones. The count of ones should be even. That's the main aim. Okay. So it may be odd also, right? Let us consider if it is even, right? So the count of ones should be even. So for that purpose, we'll take the data. So here, what is this data? So this is the data, right? This is the data. This should be transmitted from source to destination. Here count the ones, 1 and 2. That means even. The count of ones is even. So we will add 0 as an additional bit. 0 as an additional bit, because already the count of ones is even. So here this is the data and this is the even parity bit. Even parity bit, right? So this will be transmitted from source to destination. So receiver and sender. So receiver will receive the data, so that again the receiver will count the number of ones, so the last bit is a parity bit, even parity. So that implies the number of ones should be even, right? So if there is any change, for example 1 1 1 0 0 0, okay, sorry, at the receiver side, if it receives this one, as the receiver knows this is an even parity because the last bit is 0, it's an even parity, that the receiver will count the number of ones, it will getting the odd, such that the receiver will know that, there is some corruption in the data which is sent by the sender. Okay, so for that identification we'll add one parity bit. So this is called even parity. Coming to the second one, see, if you consider the data as this one, so this is the data, okay, and we have to add one bit at the end, okay, so this is the bit we have added, this is called an even parity bit, which is added to the data. Here also we have to add the parity bit, okay. So here count the number of ones, 1 2 3, the count of ones is odd, so we have to make it even, so the odd parity bit must be 1, so the 1 will be added to the data. So this is the data and this is the odd parity bit, and this will be transmitted to the receiver. So if the receiver receives the same, so that it will count the number of ones, it becomes even, right? So because the last one is appended with 1, so that the total count of ones will be odd, so that the even parity bit, I mean the odd parity bit will be appended with 1, so it becomes even. So that implies it is an original data, the data is not corrupted during the transmission. If this data is received in such a way, 1 0 0 0 1 1, this implies, so see, count the number of ones, so last one we are appending with 1, such that the number of ones should be odd, okay, right? So this is called odd parity. That means if the data contains the number of ones odd, we are appending 1 as a parity bit, okay, 1 as a parity bit to make the number of ones as even. So here if the data received in such a way, here last bit is the parity bit appended 1, that implies, so this one means odd parity. Odd parity means the number of ones should be odd. So here if you count other than this parity bit, the number of ones are even. So that the receiver will decide that this is a the data is corrupted. One bit is corrupted, right? So this will not work for two bit change. See, if you observe here, if the data is this one, okay, so 100, if it becomes 1, see, if it becomes 1, it is in, the parity bit is 1, that means the number of 1s other than the parity bit should be odd. So it is true. So the receiver doesn't know the receiver will treat it as a perfect data which is received by the sender, right? There is no corruption. The receiver will decide that there is no corruption on data, but there is a corruption because here the first bit is 1, second bit is 0, third bit is 1, but here it received 0, fourth bit is 0, but here it received 1. But according to this parity check, the last bit, the parity bit is 1, so that other than this parity bit, all the number of 1s should be odd. So that satisfies here. That satisfies here. So that implies, so even though there is a corruption on bits, the receiver doesn't know that the corruption occurs in the data, right? So that's the main drawback of this parity check. So this parity check is used for only single bit errors. So multiple bit errors can't be identified by this parity check, right? So hope you understood this parity check. So even parity, odd parity. So even parity means if the data contains even number of 1s, automatically the last parity bit will be added as 0. Odd parity means if the data contains the number of 1s in odd number, so in order to make it even, we'll add 1 as a parity bit. So this all happens in this parity, even parity and odd parity. Mainly it is used for identifying the single bit errors. What about the burst errors? Burst error means multiple errors. So this, the main drawback of this one is it can't identify the multiple errors. Right. So for this purpose, we'll move on to the next error detection method, that is CRC, that is cyclic redundancy check. Okay. So only one solution for this type of methods in the error detection is retransmission of packet. So if receiver identifies there is a corruption in the data, automatically the receiver will request the sender to the retransmission, because here these are the only meant for error detection. There will be no correction, so the receiver will only detect the error, he can't able to correct the errors, right? So error correction will not be there. So whatever the technique you take, whether it is in parity or a CRC, the only solution for this one is retransmission. And this retransmission request depends upon the error detection. If there is any error, automatically the receiver will request the sender to retransmit the data, right? So hope you understood about this parity. Let us stop here, and in the next session we'll go with the CRC, cyclic redundancy check, so which can identify the multiple bit errors in the data, right? So if you are having any doubts regarding this error detection, the parity check, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that definitely we will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my sessions, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much.